Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our kickoff little meeting for the anniversary coming up. Actually, the committee members here know that we haven't just begun, but have been doing this for a number of weeks now. So we have just a few things we want to cover tonight to make this the official day. As you know, in 1886, John McMillan established two divisions in this area that he named one Bethel and one Lebanon. And Bethel has stuck since all those years. And there's a little more history that goes with that. So I'm going to begin by reading this proclamation that covers part of the history. Whereas in 1776, the Reverend John McMillan established two divisions of his congregation, the Eastern Division being called Lebanon and the Western Division being called Bethel. And whereas Bethel was incorporated in 1886 as Bethel Township, that's 110 years later, incidentally, rich in agricultural and farmland, and by the start of the 20th century, Bethel grew as a result of advances in railroads and transportation. And whereas Pittsburgh Terminal Coal Company built Bethel's first coal mine in Mullinar in 1902, and in 1921, a model mining housing community was built in Coverdale. And whereas Pittsburgh Railway's trolley system provided transportation through the 1920s and 30s, and currently Port Authority of Allegheny County's light rail system that runs through Bethel Park and the South Hills has become a major mode of transportation. And whereas in 1949, due to enormous growth, Bethel Township was named Bethel Borough as a borough form of government, and by the 1970s had grown with residential development and commercial businesses to become a home rule municipality known as Bethel Park. So there's the change in the name. And whereas Bethel Park is nestled in Allegheny County, 8 miles south of Pittsburgh, in an area 12.5 square miles, where approximately 12,000 families of various ethnic backgrounds reside, who show pride for their community and love for their neighbors. And whereas, with the 2010 census reporting the population as 32,313 residents, the municipality of Bethel Park remains one of the largest populated suburbs in the South Hills. And whereas the municipality of Bethel Park boasts an award-winning school district, top-notch volunteer fire department, dedicated emergency medical service, highly respected municipal government and police department, spiritual congregations, community-oriented organizations, and well-established family-owned businesses. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Clifford Morton, by virtue of the authority vested in me as the mayor of Bethel Park, and on behalf of the Bethel Park Municipal Council, do hereby proclaim this day, June 7, 2011, to be known as the 125th birthday celebration of the municipality of Bethel Park, in honor of all citizens and elected officials, both past and present. There's only 10 more pages. This time I'd like to call Rich Kraft up here and let him talk a little bit about what we're doing with the time capsule. My apologies, I thought we'd have the regular case by tonight, and it didn't happen. It didn't come in, and so we're just going to do this one over here made out of strong material like fiberglass or foam or whatever. Okay, Rich, you're on.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'm very proud to serve as a committee with the mayor, getting together some items for the time capsule. And so far, I've accumulated quite a few things. I'm waiting for more to come in, but we're going to finally seal the thing on Community Day in September. So you want to be there for that one. But I have a list here of things that were in the box so far. Post Gazette newspaper dated June 7th, 19 today, 2011. A copy of the Tribune Review newspaper, the same date. Copy of the Almanac.
Speak louder.
I'm sorry. Copy of the Almanac, dated June 1st. That's the most recent issue. Bethel Park Magazine, an aerial view photograph of the present Bethel High School campus. The Bethel Park Hills approval of bills and payroll for the month of May this year. A menu from the Eaton Park Restaurant. A menu from the Warehouse Cafe. A program of the Memorial Day ceremony at Bethel Park Cemetery just this past week. An information bulletin from Christ Methodist Church. A list of farmers market vendors. A copy of the Bethel Park Chronicles. And a copy of the Bethel Park Community Guide, plus a current map of same. So I'd encourage anybody in the municipality who wants to contribute something to the time capsule itself to contact the mayor or myself. And we're looking for more input than we have right now. I just caution you, no food of any kind or nothing that contaminated that would decay within 50 years. You know, we're also going to, we're accumulating pictures of and school books from the various Bethel Park schools. So that'll be included also, including the 2011 graduating Bethel Park High School. So thank you again, Mayor.
Thank you, Dick. Thank you. He mentioned 50 years, and the reason that came up is because in 50 years we're going to, they're going to open it. We're going to stipulate on our plaque that we put up with this that they're to open it on this date in 2061. So let's hope they do that. It should be fun. Kristen, our committee chairman, has got some words she'd like to share with us. Speak loudly, Kristen, like you do. Yell at them like you yell at us at committee.
Oh, goodness. I'm going to read from this paper because I'm really bad at speaking. So it's better that I read and you can just hear from there. My name is Kristen Normile, and I'm honored to be the chairman of the Bethel Park 125th Celebration Committee, and more importantly, proud to be a Bethel Park resident. My grandparents moved to the corner of Horning and Rittenhouse in 1955, and my mom, two aunts, and uncles all graduated from Bethel Park. My grandparents eventually moved to Hillcrest Road in Oakhurst, and I lived in their home for a few years in the late 70s. I went to John McMillan Elementary School in the third and fourth grade, and I love the fact that Lynn Swan lived only five houses up from me. And back in the 70s, that was a really big deal to a little Steeler fan. I remember going to Tish Tish with my mom to get her hair done. I remember eating birthday dinners at the Steak and Ale on Washington Road. I remember my family getting Winkies, Big Winks, to go on Friday nights for dinner. I remember Arcadian Gardens and Mayfair. I remember trick-or-treating around Oakhurst and the one house who always passed out the Schneider's orange drinks. I remember thinking, this is where I want to be forever. We ultimately had to move in the summer of 1979, but my heart forever remained here in Bethel Park. When I got married and started a family, I knew it was time to come back. My husband, son, and I moved back to Bethel in 2001. I have since strived to give back to this community as much as it has given me. I have been a BPTO mom, a BCL baseball assistant coach, a Bethel Park Foundation trustee, and now an author of a book on my favorite town. None of this was done singularly. It was done with the immense support of Bethel Park as a whole. We have an amazing community of dedicated, caring, proud people who are always willing to give the best of themselves for the good of Bethel Park. That's a rare thing. We live in a community of over 33,000 people, yet I feel as close to all of you as if we were in a community of 100. We all come together to make Bethel Park a very special place for our families, neighbors, and friends, and not just as individuals, but as businesses, schools, churches, and organizations too. As for Bethel Park 125, I was writing the back cover to the Bethel Park book last year, and I realized that it was going to be the 125th anniversary of Bethel Park. I went in to talk with Mayor Morton and asked him if the community was doing anything for it. And he said, are you sure? We just had the 100th anniversary a few years ago. So time flies, doesn't it? After some quick math and a laugh, he said we should do something. And he put together an amazing committee of talented Bethel Park people within weeks. I had the privilege to work with amazing people on the Bethel Park 125th Committee. Mayor Morton, Autumn Metzmeyer, Tracy Fedko, Dick and Pat Kraft, Kathy Lordi, Joe and Diane Kletch, Chuck Stover, Jim McLean, Kathy Moscato, John and Chris Walsh, Julie Lytle, Dave Cable, Christine McIntosh, Kim Waitman, Dan Duff, Scott Zinsmeister, Pauletta Beeler, Sherry Tishy, Connie Rule, Diane Ford, Nancy Meyer, and Lori Gibbons. They have worked hard and implemented some great ideas. Now here we are on the 125th birthday of Bethel Park. Tonight is the first of some great community events and activities through the summer. Thank you to Dick and Pat Kraft and Mayor Morton for organizing this special 125th ceremony and time capsule dedication this evening. Thank you to Paul Henney for donating the time capsule. It's not here yet, but it will be. Thank you to Bethel Bakery for the cupcakes later that you can all have some. Here are some of the events still planned for the summer. The Oliver Miller Homestead is offering reenacted history tours in historic Bethel Cemetery on Saturday, July 23rd and Saturday, October 15th. The committee is planning a black and orange ball on August 27th, Saturday, with the municipality, and the municipality is gearing up for a terrific 125th Community Day, starting with the parade and Grand Marshal Rick Seaback, writer, producer, and iconic voice of WQED. During the day, you can enjoy Bethel Bakery's amazing Bethel Park 125th birthday cake and enter their cupcake eating contest. The school district will be offering tours of the old high school campus and is planning an old-fashioned sock hop in the high school gym. And we also have to thank our great local 125th sponsors for helping make all these special events a reality. Al's Cafe, Allsop's Lawn Service, Beinhauer Family Funeral Homes, Bethel Bakery, Bethel Park Printing, the Bethel Park Community Foundation, the Bethel Park Fencing Club, Bethel Park Junior Football, the Bethel Park Library, the Bethel Park Lions Club, the members of Bethel Park's Municipal Council, the Bethel Park Police Association, the Bethel Park Recreation Swim Team, the Bethel Park Rotary Club, the Bethel Park School District, Bethel Park Soccer, Bethel Presbyterian Church, Brentwood Bank, Brookside Lumber, Brewster's Real Ice Cream of Bethel Park, Dairy Queen Orange Julius of Bethel Park. Turn the page. Evie's True Value Hardware, Family Deli, First National Bank, Fergasso Financial Advisors, Freddy's Restaurant and Grill, Giant Eagle Market District in Bethel Park, Healthcare Benefits, Heisler Painting, The Heritage Players, Hillcrest Christian Academy, Justice Robert Wida, Capusta Financial Group, Lois Johnson Learning and Child Care Center, Maisel's Auto Body, Megan Remington, Miller's Ace Hardware, New Song Community Church, Northwood Realtors Ann and Corinna Alsop, O Creations, Pasta 2, Paul L. Henney Memorial Chapel, Representative Matt Smith, RG Raider Graphics, Rotary Club of Bethel Park Upper St. Clair, Route 88 Self Storage, Senator John Pippi, South Hills Assembly, South Hills Interfaith Ministries, the South Hills YMCA, South Park Shops, St. Valentine's Parish, Supreme Cleaners, Tudor Doctor, and the UPS store in South Park Shops. As I said, of all the communities that have come together, the whole entire community has come together to make this a really special year. There's no better place to be than in Bethel Park, and I thank you very much and have a happy 125th birthday, Bethel.
Thank you. Very good, very good. I would like you and you and you to come up here, please. You three guys, come up here, please. Don't stand with your back to the camera. Come up here and smile. Pretty girls always smile, don't you know that? All right, now, how old are you, son?
12.
Can you add 12 and 50?
That's 62.
You're 62. That's your number. How old are you?
12.
Same? 62?
12.
62? How old are you?
10.
Can you add 50 to that?
60.
60.
10.
10? Oh, that's 60. And you, sweetie?
12.
What did we say that was? 62. In 50 years, you're going to be 62. You're going to be 62. You're going to be 62. You're going to be 60 in that area. There's no reason at age 61, 2, or 3 that you won't be here with your children, perhaps your grandchildren. And you can say, I was at the 125th anniversary, and we got a picture to prove it. And who would like to say something? You ever notice how a microphone just chases away people? Say something to everybody.
I'm good.
Yeah, you don't want to say anything. All right.
Go Bethel Park.
Go Bethel Park. All right. All right. So, if you folks are living here in Bethel, make sure you go to the opening of this thing, and they'll be celebrating the next 50 years after that. So, say, I was there. All right. Anything else we need to do here? Okay. Jack, do you or Jim have anything you want to add here? I hope.
Yes.
All right.
You could. We would appreciate it. I just want to say that, you know, it's a kickoff to a great season for Bethel Park, and the committee, who has really kept council up to date on what they're doing, is incredible. They showed up at my store today with their balloons and a little sticker that they're doing to all the businesses, so it's definitely a first-class operation, and I want to thank everyone that's on that committee.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. I just want to let everyone know I too am grateful for the opportunity to have served on the 125th committee. It's been a wonderful thing for me to see how many different parts of this community have come together to form that committee and to get this started and to get it off the ground in a relatively short period of time. But really, it's come from about every facet of the community, from the government side, from the school, from the churches, from the businesses, and it's wonderful. And you can tell when you drive around now from today through the rest of the summer, you'll see the banners hanging all over town, and they're going to have the names of everybody who's contributed that gave us that little bit of push we needed to get started. And there'll be a whole summer and into the fall set of events that'll continue to celebrate the 125th and Bethel Park in particular. So I'm glad to be involved, and Mary, you've done a wonderful job of putting all this together. Thank you very much.
Bill, are you on or not? All right. Our manager, Bill Spagnuolo.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Well, thank you, and Mrs. Mayor, and members of council for letting me, Bill Spagnuolo, be municipal manager and serve this community that I grew up in for quite a few years. I remember I grew up in Bethel Park. I went to St. Germain's Elementary School, Bethel High School, and I remember back when we didn't call the T, it was the trolley. And also I remember going way back when the intersection at St. Germain's at Baptist and Horning Road, where there was the old Pickering milk farm, dairy farm, and they had an electrified barbed wire fence. And I remember as a little kid going up and putting my hands on it and getting a nice shock, and I didn't do that. I learned quickly, didn't do that again. But we're still a growing community, almost 34,000 people, one of the largest communities in Allegheny County. We're still developing, still redeveloping, and there's a commitment of Bethel Park residents to the community is well known. There's a lot of vitality in the community, and even members of our staff. I grew up in Bethel Park. My wife, Leslie, grew up in Bethel Park. So did the assistant manager, Judy Miller. Our finance director grew up in Bethel Park, Mark Romito. One of my former police chiefs, Joe Kletch, was a Bethel Park native. And I think there's a real commitment to the community, doing the best we can for the public, as well as all the other staff members that service, like Bob Segrimis, Dave Cable, who's doing this tonight, Chuck Stover. We have a great team. We have a great council, a good mayor. And Bethel Park, I think, is going to only continue to get better and better every year. And hopefully 50 years from now, maybe we'll all be here and we can celebrate it. 50 years from now. So thank you very much, Mayor.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Remember, guys, 50 years from now, you could be on council. You could be Bill Spagnuolo. You could be working anything. There's lots of jobs in the community. All right, what else? What else we got? All right. Autumn, go get them.
I'm looking for the longest residing, continuously residing resident that lives in Bethel Park. If you could please stop by the library or contact Nancy Myers so that we can have you be part of our Community Day parade, possibly ride on a float or be one of our grand marshals, we would appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay. Yes, we are looking for the longest living resident in Bethel Park. So if you know of them, if you have any ideas, do as Autumn's mentioned. Get a hold of Nancy. All right, and the library. Anything else we're missing that we should be doing here tonight? Yes, sir. You don't, well, 3 minutes.
I'll be quick. I also forgot to mention Kathy Lordi, who has been doing a lot. Kathy Lordi, who's done a lot of great work for us, and I would be totally remiss if I didn't mention her name. So. Thank you, Kathy. Thank you, Mayor.
Sorry, Kathy. All right, anything else? If not, we're going to call this meeting to a close, and see you at the next event. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you, Dave. Thank you, Bob, for everything.
Thank you. Hello, this is Nancy Meyer, and I'm a resident of Bethel Park. Did you know that our wonderful community is 125 years old this year? Well, it is, and we're searching for that person who has lived here longer than anyone else. We have lots of activities going on over the next few months, and we'd like to honor that special person who has lived here continuously for the longest period of time. Just come up to the library and look for the flowered box on the circulation desk. Give us your name, the date you moved here, and your contact information. You can nominate yourself or nominate someone that you know. I'll be calling you to let you know how we will honor you as our very special resident. And please watch for information about all the other special activities that are going to be coming up in our community over the next few months to celebrate our 125th anniversary.
So we're gonna continue the puppy thing real quick.
Okay, places everyone.
In a minute!
Do I have to do everything myself?
You can't do it all by yourself.
I'd say that...
Sure I can,
No, he can't. And neither can I. So why don't you come on down to BPTV and help us make some of the great community programs you see on this station every day.
Yeah!
I mean, we can help you make your TV show ideas a reality.
It's pretty awesome.
So come on down. I mean, I am pretty good. But I'm sure I can use your help.